How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All right, what did I get up to?
Hello, everybody. Welcome to How Many, the only podcast on the internet that counts. I am Junior. With me is Bob and Gary. Scott and Jesse are currently not with us. This is an impromptu episode that we tried to spring together. We just got through the NBA draft, and we thought it would be a good topic to look at the past first overall picks in the NBA draft, starting from 1990 and working our way up into the 2000s and current. Now, obviously, some of the more recent number one picks we're going to have a hard time debating, but we wanted to see how many of the number one overall picks did not live up to number one overall pick expectations. And when I say that, I mean they may have ended up having a decent NBA career, but if they were just a role player, I wouldn't consider that number one overall pick quality. When I say no number one overall pick, I'm thinking all-star selections, all-NBA, MVPs, titles won. To me, that's where we get into expectations of number one overall pick. So we have a list of 32 names, including the most recent ones. So let's get some guesses out. Of those 32, how many of them do you feel lived up to the number one overall pick expectations? And we'll start with Bob.
So out of the 32, I'll say 20.
I'll go next. I think it's going to be a little bit higher. I'm going to go 23, Michael Jordan number. Gary, what are you thinking?
I think both of you are high. I'm going to go 12.
Whoa.
Oh, he went way, way under.
Man, you're going to hate on a lot of these selections. Starting at 90, we have the number one overall pick selected by the New Jersey Nets. Can you guys remember who was number one overall in 1990?
Derek Coleman?
With the first pick in the 1990 NBA draft, the New Jersey Nets select Derek Coleman from Syracuse.
Bob is right. From the University of Syracuse, Derek Coleman was the number one overall pick. Now, I do remember Derek Coleman made some all-star teams. He had a pretty decent career, never really had any kind of playoff success, but I wouldn't necessarily call him a spare. Now, towards the end of his career, I think he got a little bit out of shape and kind of spared it up. I'm kind of on the fence on him.
He's very much
he's borderline
in the middle. I feel like he definitely would be a first round pick, but would he 1-1? Unless he is.
If you were to put a gun to my head, I would say yes, because I think he had some pretty good years.
He had 3 years where he was a 20-10 guy.
Pretty solid.
And he had
three times?
I mean,
1-1.
And how 20-10 is pretty difficult.
How many years was he in the league?
From 90 to 04, so 15,
yeah. 14.
So he had a long career. What is his career average there? What, 16.5?
16 points, 9 rebounds. 16 and 9 is a good basketball player. It really is.
It's good.
I'm not saying Derek Coleman couldn't play, but 1-1?
Yeah, I'm going to say no. I'm going to say no. Yeah.
If he had any kind of playoff success, I could get talked into a yes, but – just a 16-point average wasn't really dominant, right? We'll say no for Derek Coleman.
All right.
Moving into 91, the Charlotte Hornets. Do you guys remember who was the number one overall pick in 1991?
Grandmama.
With the first pick in the 1991 NBA draft, the Charlotte Hornets select Larry Johnson from University of Nevada, Las Vegas.
Grandmama Larry Johnson from the University of UNLV was the number one overall pick. He is very similar to Coleman.
Well,
in that he won Rookie of the Year, just like Coleman, I believe, did. And he had some pretty good years.
Not many, though. See, that's the thing. I think he was better than Derek Coleman when he played, but he didn't play long. He had injuries.
He did have injuries. Well, I will say, though, he was part of that Knicks team that went to the finals in 99. Played the Spurs. So he did help his team have some playoff success. When he was with the Hornets, though, not really, not so much.
And it looks like his numbers weren't even quite as good as Coleman's.
They're not. He had one 20-10 season. He had 22 points, 10.5 rebounds his second year, 19-11 the year before. So it was almost 20-10. After that, his scoring drops down to 16, 18 points a game, and his rebounds drop down to sub 10. I mean, yeah, I love the guy. You know, he's a Dallas guy. He was a lot of fun to watch, especially his commercials, but 1-1, it's not, I don't see it.
Yeah, from a pop culture standpoint, he definitely was a little bit more popular than Coleman. And his commercials were funny, like Gary said. But yeah, I could see this being a no.
I'm kind of surprised that his numbers weren't as good as Coleman's. I kind of remembered him a little bit better.
Well, towards the end of Larry Johnson's career, I think he really just became a role player more than anything.
Yeah, but the last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years of his career, and his career was only 10 years to begin with. So for half of his career, he was a 12, 13, 14 points per game scorer. They got a couple of rebounds. But, yeah, he was a role player with the Knicks. Now, unlike Coleman, he did play deeper in the playoffs. Coleman never had more than 5 games in any playoffs.
And I remember there was one, he had like a 4-point play at the end of the game that got them past, I want to say it was the Pacers.
Johnson is fouled and hit! Larry Johnson has hit his career quota of wild shots today.
He was kind of clutch when he was with the Knicks, but yeah, I'm good with a no here. All right, so moving on to 1992, the Orlando Magic. You guys remember who was number one? Yeah. Not Penny.
Oh, Tracy McGrady?
No. Shaq?
With the first pick in the 1992 NBA draft, the Orlando Magic selects Shaquille O'Neal from Louisiana State University.
That would be Shaquille O'Neal from the University of LSU, 1992.
I thought he already would have been.
That's the
first ballot. No-brainer. Definitely won plenty of titles, scoring titles. Definitely lived up to it.
Yeah.
Now, what's funny is 1993, Orlando had the number one overall pick again. Ended up trading it for the person you just mentioned, Penny Hardaway. But who was their actual number one pick?
Alonzo Mourning?
Nope.
I don't know.
With the first pick in the 1993 NBA draft, the Orlando Magic select Chris Webber.
This would be Chris Webber, who they took number one overall. Ended up trading Webber to Golden State for Penny Hardaway.
I would count Webber.
Definitely better than Derek Coleman. Had playoff success. Never won a title. Yeah. But I think he recently made the Hall of Fame, didn't he?
He may have. He was the main reason that those Kings teams made the playoffs for all those years.
I'm going to say yes on Webber. Coleman had the 3 years that he was a 20-10 guy, but he was literally 20-10 guy. Whereas Chris Webber had several of his 20-10 seasons, 24.5 points, 27 points, 23 points, and his rebounds aren't necessarily just 10. He's got, here's a year with 13, another year with over 11. Yeah. Long career, 20-10 guy for the career. Yeah. Yes to Webber.
Next up, 1994, the Milwaukee Bucks. Do you guys remember who the Bucks took in 1994?
Paul Pressey.
No, he was an 80s guy.
Oh, Glenn Davis?
Close. Not Big Baby, but the big dog.
Glenn Dog.
Glenn Robinson.
With the first pick in the 1994 NBA draft, the Milwaukee Bucks select Glenn Robinson from Purdue University.
Glenn Robinson, you're right. University of Purdue. His career was kind of interesting. This first couple of years, he was really good. He was an all-star. I would say he was on his trajectory to be someone that we would include on this list. But then I think injuries hit him and he got kind of spare, turned into a role player. By the end of his career, he ended up, I want to say, winning a title with the Spurs, but he was a bench guy. I think he kind of falls into the Larry Johnson mold.
His numbers actually are better than I remember. He was over 20 most seasons.
Yeah, but that's pretty much it. He's a 6-rebound guy. A lot of 20-point scoring, though. He could score.
When he was with the Bucks, that team also had Sam Cassell, and Ray Allen in his early years. They had a pretty decent team that went to the playoffs, but they didn't really have a lot of playoff success when he was with the Bucks.
Not only that, but his scoring dipped in the playoffs.
Yeah, I wouldn't count him.
Good player.
Yes.
But I would say no. Moving into 1995, the Golden State Warriors had the number one overall pick. Do you guys remember who Golden State took number one overall in 95?
No.
And I will say this person had the most generic name that you could possibly have.
Josh Smith or something like that?
Close. Well, University of Maryland. Not Josh Smith, but Joe Smith.
Joe Smith.
With the first pick in the 1995 NBA draft, the Golden State Warriors select Joe Smith from the University of Maryland.
That's right.
1995.
No, he was a spare.
He was a role player, spare. But it is funny, though, that he was involved with one of the bigger trades when he got traded to Minnesota. In fact, I think I want to say there was some kind of controversy around him, either as a trade or free agent, where it cost Minnesota some picks because there was some kind of tampering involved. But you're right. He was, I don't think he lived up to number one overall pick criteria. 1996, we have the Philadelphia 76ers. Do you guys remember who Philadelphia took number one overall? I will say this person will definitely count.
Iverson.
With the first pick in the 1996 NBA draft, the Philadelphia 76ers select Allen Iverson from Georgetown University.
Allen Iverson, the University of Georgetown. Consensus, he was greatness,
yes.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Hall of Famer. Took a pretty spare 76ers team to the finals. Had some playoff success.
He underachieved at times, but he counts.
Yeah.
Well, he's a volume shooter. Well, he doesn't shoot high percentages, but.
Plus, he never practiced, right?
We're talking about practice. Not a game. We're talking about practice.
Yeah. So we'll say yes to the great Allen Iverson.
Here's me and team, though.
Now, 1997, the San Antonio Spurs selected some spare.
With the first pick in the 1997 NBA draft, the San Antonio Spurs select Tim Duncan from Wake Forest University.
Tim Duncan failed.
So rigged.
I don't know.
Oh, my back.
I don't even know if he had a better career than Joe Smith.
The rear admiral faking a back pain like Bob.
You know why the admiral's back was jacked up? Is having to duck to get him on those submarines before he started playing.
Or having to carry the team on his back for the first 10 years. Obviously, Tim Duncan counts. 5 titles.
Yes.
Hall of Famer. Now, 1998, the Los Angeles Clippers select somebody number one.
With the first pick in the 1998 NBA draft, the Los Angeles Clippers select Michael Olowokandi from University of Pacific.
Yes, the candy man, Michael Olowokandi from the University of Pacific. He is the quintessential number one bust overall pick.
Yeah. So it was Olowokandi, Bibby, LaFrance. Oh, Vince Carter went 5th.
Oh,
and then, of course, Dirk 9th.
Before Dirk, other than Vince Carter, I mean, Jameson was okay, but you got spares ahoy on that list.
Jason Williams had a pretty decent run.
Jason Williams was a good player on a
Bibby,
bad team.
He was okay.
Obviously, Pierce is a Hall of Famer. But yeah, Bonzi Wells, Michael Doliak, Keon Clark, and massive spares. In line with a spare draft for the most part, Olowokandi was a spare number one overall pick. So we will say no to the Candyman. So moving into 1999 from the Chicago Bulls, who did they take with the number one overall pick? It would have been Elton Brand from the University of Duke.
With the first pick in the 1999 NBA draft, the Chicago Bulls select Elton Brand from Duke University.
He may have had a decent career, but he's kind of in that mid-range. Yeah, he's kind of in the Larry Johnson, Glenn Robinson.
That's a lot of 20 and 10 seasons, but I think there's a lot of empty numbers in there.
And I don't really remember him having a lot of playoff success on any of the teams he was on.
Only 2 years.
End of the second round twice.
Yeah,
I would give him a no.
A pretty good individual numbers, good player, just not a 1-1.
All right, moving into 2000, the New Jersey Nets selected somebody. Do you guys recall who they took in 2000?
Would have been
Marbury?
Not Marbury. I think Marbury was on the team.
Yeah. I got nothing.
This would have been lip tattoo on the neck himself.
Oh.
Kenyon Martin.
Kenyon Martin, who knows?
With the first pick in the 2000 NBA draft, the New Jersey Nets select Kenyon Martin from the University of Cincinnati.
He was a 1-1?
He was a 1-1 from the University of Cincinnati. Yeah. I think he falls into that, you know, Larry Johnson, Derek Coleman.
He's Fugazi. Yeah. Fugazi.
Crazy Fugazi, it's a wazzy, it's a woozy, it's a fairy dust. It doesn't exist. It's never landed. It is no matter. It's not on the elemental chart.
He was a very tough guy.
Is he one of those guys that they have to fake hold back? Like, you know, like NBA fights where they have to, like, do the holding back the guy.
The lips on his neck, I don't think were fake, though. I think some dude did do that.
I wouldn't look at his neck. I'll strawberry it up.
What you looking at, man?
Oh, nothing. I wasn't looking. I wasn't looking at his neck, man.
So I would give him a no, right?
Yeah.
No.
Although he did have some playoff success, went to multiple finals with the
Nets. Mean, he had playoff success because he had Jason Kidd setting him up.
He was always like a third or fourth option.
All right. Moving into 2001, the Washington Wizards selected somebody. Do you guys recall who they picked up with the number one overall pick?
Oh, Arenas.
No.
No.
No, Arenas was a second.
This is another high bust meter guy.
I got nothing.
Yeah.
It would be Kwame Brown.
Oh, wow.
Lynn Academy. Boy, so he didn't go to college.
With the first pick in the 2001 NBA draft, the Washington Wizards select Kwame Brown from Lynn Academy, Brunswick, Georgia.
That's like really bad.
Yeah, that's sub Olo candy.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, I think Kwame Brown actually had a pretty long career.
He did. He was a role player.
But he was, he was a spare. And I don't even think that Olo candy lasted that long in the NBA. So he's probably a little bit better than Olo candy, but
he only hit 10 points a season once.
I think the biggest problem with him was he had really bad hands. He had stone hands.
Edward Penis hands?
Pretty much, yeah.
When he was at the Lakers, didn't Kobe hate him or Shaq? They, like, ran him off.
I mean, 7 points and one rebound? Yeah, they didn't want him around.
So I think we'll give Kwame Brown a no. Moving into 2002, the Houston Rockets selected somebody 1-1. You guys remember
who it was?
Not Steve Francis. It was Yao Ming from the Shanghai Sharks.
With the first pick in the 2002 NBA draft, the Houston Rockets select Yao Ming from Shanghai, China, and the Shanghai Sharks.
Boy, this is also a tough one.
I don't think so. He was pretty dominant in the first part of his career.
Short career, man.
Didn't have huge playoff success, but injuries obviously took.
See, that's tough for me. Like, Bob's right. First of all, it took him 4 years to get to 20 points a game. Now, the last 4 years of his career, 22, 25, 22, 19, 7, and he was never a big rebound guy. For a guy that big, he only averaged 10 rebounds twice.
I mean, I feel like he had 2 or 3 years where he was definitely a 1-1, but is that enough to qualify?
Didn't have huge playoff success that I can recall. And I don't believe he's a Hall of Famer, right?
If he is, it's just they're
on name.
Yeah, name. And
I don't see it. I don't see a 1-1.
Okay, then we will say no to Yao Ming. Moving into 2003, the Cleveland Cavaliers selected somebody 1-1.
Wrong name.
With the first pick in the 2003 NBA draft, the Cleveland Cavaliers select LeBron James.
That would be LeBron James. Yeah, I think he's probably a first ballot.
Yeah.
Won enough titles.
You could say it like that, or you could say he's in the conversation for the greatest player ever.
All time.
Definitely a one.
Begrudgingly, I will agree with
you. I think Jordan's number one, but I'm just saying he's in the conversation.
Definitely.
Yeah.
He's been to what, like 10 finals, something like that?
Yeah.
Didn't win them all, but he definitely carried a lot of bad teams to playoff success. All right, moving into 2004, the Orlando Magic selected somebody 1-1. Do you guys recall who that was? Another high school player.
O'Neal. Not Shaq.
No, O'Neal. We talked about like
Jermaine? No, not Jermaine O'Neal.
Not Jermaine O'Neal. It was Dwight Howard was the 1-1.
With the first pick in the 2004 NBA draft, the Orlando Magic select Dwight Howard from Southwest Christian Academy.
Now, he's another borderline guy. Won multiple Defensive Player of the Year awards, was an all-star, did lead his team to the finals that lost to the Lakers.
He just
almost, I would lean towards yes on him more than
the
no.
The first half of his career through Atlanta, he was playing like a 1-1.
I feel like he just...
After Atlanta, or at the end of Atlanta, his wheels started shooting off all over the place.
Yeah.
And he's been a guy since then.
I want to say he was better than Derek Coleman.
I just feel like he's one of these guys that always got kind of labeled an underachiever. Like, that people expected more out of him than what they got.
I mean, maybe, but like, so first year he only averaged 12, second year he averaged 15. But even starting in year one, he's a 10-rebound guy. And he's always right around 2 blocks a game, 3 blocks a game.
Yeah.
Defensively, he's probably about as good as you're going to find in that run. About, what, 9 years, almost 9-10 years? Where he was really, really dominant. As he left Houston, left the Lakers for Houston in 2012, scoring drops, rebounding drops.
Now, he did win a title with the Lakers, I want to say the bubble year.
I'm not sure that matters.
And he did, during his prime with Orlando, he did get them to the finals.
He definitely was a head case, but... I think
he's a career 15-11 guy that averages 2 blocks a game, and he was never an offensive threat.
Defensively, he was always one of the best.
Yeah, he was a monster. I'd say yes to him. But that's when we start drawing lines. This is a line to me. Yeah. This is yes, but he's a bottom of the barrel yes.
Yeah, I'm going to say yes too. All right, moving into 2005, the Milwaukee Bucks selected someone. Do you guys recall who they took? 1-1.
Paul Pressey?
Man, lots of Paul Pressey guesses. It would be Andrew Bogut
out of Bogut. The University of Utah. How do you remember him being a 1-1? Jeez.
With the first pick in the 2005 NBA draft, the Milwaukee Bucks select Andrew Bogut from Australia and the University of Utah.
That's a good role player for a long time. That's it.
And I think he won a title with the Golden State.
Yes.
It's basically a second-round pick going 1-1.
Yeah. No, he's not a second-round pick, dude. Andrew Bogut is better than that. That's ridiculous.
He was okay, but I wouldn't consider him a legitimate 1-1 for this list.
I mean, offensively, he was better than Dwight Howard. Like, he didn't score 20 points a game, but he wasn't a scrub on offense.
Yeah.
He just didn't get utilized on offense. But, you know, there were years where he was a 10-11 rebound guy. There are years where he's a 12-15-point scorer, 14-point scorer.
Solid role player.
But, yeah, he was a role player. There's nothing more. But if you're getting that out of a second-round pick, that's a monster second-round pick.
Yeah. All right, so we'll say no to Andrew Bogut. Moving into 2006, the Toronto Raptors selected somebody 1-1. Do you guys recall who went 1-1 in 2006?
The Raptors.
I don't know.
Foreign player.
Danilo Gallinari?
No. It would be Andrea Bargnani.
Oh, Bargnani. Dang it.
From Benetton Treviso.
With the first pick in the 2006 NBA draft, the Toronto Raptors select Andrea Bargnani from Italy.
That I would consider a bust.
Yes.
He wasn't even a good role player.
Hey, Bargnani had years where he averaged over 20 points.
Did he?
Yeah.
I don't remember him being that great.
He had 21.4 right there, 19.5 right there, 2011, 2012. He had a little run there where he's a very functional, good player. But nothing more than a role player.
Yeah.
There was never anything more than that.
Never had any playoff success that I can recall.
But I mean, that's a 7-footer that's shooting 37%, 35% from three. 36%.
He was one of the people at the center position that was kind of extending their range, probably patterned his game after Dirk's game a little bit. All right, 2007, Portland Trailblazers.
LaMarcus Aldridge?
No. Portland took this guy and...
Knees?
Bad knees.
Odin.
With the first pick in the 2007 NBA draft, the Portland Trailblazers select
Greg Oden from Ohio State University.
Greg Oden from the University of Ohio State had terrible knees and had old man face when he was in college.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, when they said he was drafted, he was drafted when he was like 20 years old. They said he looked like he had been in Vietnam.
Yes, definitely. The knees pretty much killed his career right off the bat. He never really...
That is sucking.
I'll stand Louis up.
I think if he had been healthy, he probably would have been a good defensive center. I don't know how good his offensive game would have been. But his career never really ever got off the ground. He was drafted hurt, and it just never went anywhere. Only had a couple of seasons in the
NBA, he went 3 years without playing at all.
Well, he didn't play at all the first year. Then he played 2 years. Then he didn't play at all for 3 years. Then he had a very brief comeback with Miami for 20
games. And the most games he ever played in a season was
61.
So we're going to say no to Greg Oden.
How about no?
How about no?
Next up, 2008 Chicago Bulls. Do you remember who they picked up?
Love?
Kevin Love?
No, not Kevin Love. Derek Love.
Derek Love? Who is that? You're partly right.
With the first pick in the 2008 NBA draft, the Chicago Bulls select Derrick Rose from the University of Memphis.
Derrick Rose?
Rose!
Now, Derrick Rose won an MVP during his time with the Bulls. Had some playoff success. Towards the end of his career, he's not necessarily...
He had injury problems.
Yeah, had injury problems, but he would be above the threshold, I think, of what we have agreed upon.
Yeah, I would count him.
I would count him just because he was... Talent-wise and what he showed, he was definitely worth a 1-1.
And he had kind of a resurgence. He was really great.
Well, he's come back as a role player.
Yeah.
But he was fantastic that first 4 or 5 years.
He definitely led his team during that time that he did have good playoff runs.
4 playoff years there where he was over 20, you know.
So we'll say yes to Derrick Rose.
Yeah, I'll say yes. Yeah.
2009, the Los Angeles Clippers selected somebody 1-1. Do you guys remember who they picked?
No.
The guy the Mavs tried to get that got locked in the house.
He was a hit.
Not DeAndre Jordan, but he was in the house.
With the first pick in the 2009 NBA draft, the Los Angeles Clippers select Blake Griffin.
Yes, Blake Griffin was selected 1-1. Now, he's another guy that first part of his career was really good. He had some injuries. Got traded around to a couple of different teams, and now it's kind of considered a spare.
I would count him. It's close, but...
I don't think it's even close. He wasn't a huge rebound guy. First couple of years, he was good on rebounding. But, I mean, his scoring, 22, 20, 24, 21, 21, 21, 21. Yeah, he's a career 28 guy. His dunks and everything were amazing. That's a big part of being 1-1 is having crowds just want to come watch you.
Yeah.
And everybody wanted to come watch this guy play.
Yeah, he was a great dunker, won the slam dunk contest when he jumped over the key.
Yeah.
From a pop culture standpoint, too, a lot of people would recognize the name immediately. I would say yes to Blake Griffin.
Yeah,
so.
I'll say yes.
2010, the Washington Wizards select somebody number 1 overall. Do you guys remember who that was?
Beal?
Not Bradley Beal. Same backcourt.
John Wall.
Yes.
John Wall. With the first pick in the 2010 NBA draft, the Washington Wizards select John Wall from the University of Kentucky.
It is Ja Wall from the University of Kentucky. Another guy that start of his career was really good, but has become a spare at this point. His contract is so ridiculous, it's basically used as cap filler to facilitate other people's contracts.
He's been
a couple of years where he hasn't even played at all.
I don't think he quite makes it, man.
Even in the years that he played, then he had a stretch where he played 70 to 80 games 4 times, but then he stopped playing again. This is like the difference. There's like a teeter-totter with him and Derrick Rose. And Derrick Rose is just good enough that even though he was hurt, he was good enough. And John Wall, you kind of look at him and you think, what could have been, but I think he's a little bit of a knucklehead, which for me makes him a no.
I would say no as well.
Yep.
So we will not count y'all Wall. 2011, the Cleveland Cavaliers have the number 1 overall pick.
With the first pick in the 2011 NBA draft, the Cleveland Cavaliers select Kyrie Irving from Duke University.
Yes, this was after LeBron left, and they tried their rebuild with Kyrie Irving out of the University of Duke.
Back-to-back knuckleheads, but Kyrie's actually lived up to the talent.
Yes.
Agreed.
COVID stuff aside where he didn't want to get vaccinated.
Flat Earth.
And he flat Earth and you know, only plays home games because he can't play away games or something like that. He is a very good player. Won an NBA championship with LeBron. Very good player. I would say yes.
Yeah.
Moving on to 2012, the New Orleans Pelicans selected somebody in 2012. Anthony Davis?
With the first pick in the 2012 NBA draft, the New Orleans Hornets select Anthony Davis.
You are correct. The unibrow himself,
Anthony Davis. He's been around for 10 years.
He certainly has. University of Kentucky. He's got some all-star selections. He won a title with LeBron in the bubble.
Man, I'm not a fan of him.
This is really tough.
I don't think he's that great. He was. He should have been, but he's another guy. I think his time in New Orleans was bad for him.
Yeah, because he's had some injury issues, too.
Another thing that kind of works against Anthony Davis is he kind of forced his way out of New Orleans, took the easy route just so he could get teamed up with LeBron, which is the only reason he won a championship.
Only reason we're doing this.
Definitely a 20-plus, 24, 25, 28, and 10 guy. He was definitely that for that last couple of years in New Orleans. Pretty close to that with the Lakers. He's a 21.
Like 24 career.
Yeah, he's a 24 and 10 guy for his career. I can't deny the numbers, but man, those stats feel empty. I'm going to say yes, but I'm not a fan. Like Bob said, the way that he forced his way out of New Orleans and then riding coattails to a – I understand he put up 26 and 9. I'm not a big fan of his game. I think his game has regressed.
Yeah, and his injuries have certainly hurt his game.
He tells everybody he doesn't want to play center. You're 7 feet tall and 270 pounds. You don't want to play center? What do you want to play, point?
Yeah. There's definitely things I don't like about Anthony Davis. Also, he basically quieted his way out of New Orleans. But
and he insists on shooting threes. The guy shoots 26% on threes.
But I think we have to say yes, right?
Yeah, I wasn't going to count him until I saw the numbers.
Moving into 2013, the Cleveland Cavaliers again had the number one overall pick.
Oh,
man, for this run so far, they have had a lot of number one overall picks in the time that we've been looking at this list.
Yeah.
It is not Andrew Wiggins. This person is one of the most notorious.
Yeah. Oh, Anthony.
The guy from the UNLV.
Bennett? Yes, Bennett. Anthony Bennett from UNLV.
With the first pick in the 2013 NBA draft, the Cleveland Cavaliers select Anthony Bennett. Whoa! Of Toronto, Canada. Las Vegas.
Whoa. Massive bust.
Massive, massive bust. He's in the Olo Candy level, even though Olo Candy may have even been better.
Than Olo Candy was definitely.
I don't even remember Anthony Bennett playing.
Like, no, he's like the Tim Couch of the NBA.
I mean, Tim Couch actually started games and played. I can't even recall what kind of numbers he put up when Anthony Bennett was
for like, what, 3 or 4 years?
It feels like he spent more time in the G League than he did in the NBA.
Career was over in 4 years, never averaged more than 5.2 points.
And played for 4 teams in 4 years.
Yeah.
He may be the worst player on this list.
So he was the number one pick in the draft by Cleveland, and he played 52 games for Cleveland. He was then sent to Minnesota. That was the Wiggins team. Played 57 games for Minnesota. Then he ends up the next year in Toronto, plays 19 games in Toronto, and then he plays 23 games the following year for Brooklyn. That's it. That's his career, 151 games.
And out of that 151 games, he started 4. So you've got a 1-1 that only started 4 games in 4 seasons.
He is very likely the worst player on this list.
Yes.
So we will say no to Anthony Bennett. Now, speaking of Andrew Wiggins, 2014, Cleveland again had the number one overall pick. That's got to be at least 4 or 5 times that they've had the number one overall pick since we've been looking at this list. Andrew Wiggins was selected 1-1 out of the University of Kansas.
With the first pick in the 2014 NBA draft, the Cleveland Cavaliers select Andrew Wiggins from Toronto and the University of Kansas.
Now, he just recently won an NBA championship and was a big part of the playoff run this year.
Yeah, he's actually finally starting to hit his stride. Yeah,
it took him a long time to live up to his potential.
For right now, check with me in 5 years. Right now, he's enough.
Yeah, I would agree.
I would agree, too. I think
he's a good basketball player. He really is, but he's not a one-on-one.
Yeah, I would agree. He's not lifting his team up. I think he's just good in the situation he's in right now. But I wouldn't expect him to carry any teams, which I think a 1-1 would need to.
But I'll give him credit for being better now than he was when he started.
Yeah, he's definitely improved. And the fact that he's on a team with a bunch of Hall of Famers probably helps as well. Moving into 2015, the Minnesota Timberwolves selected somebody 1-1.
Big Cat.
With the first pick in the 2015 NBA draft, the Minnesota Timberwolves select Karl Anthony Towns. From the University of Kentucky.
That would be Big Cat, Karl Anthony Towns.
Self-professed best shooting big man ever. No.
Did win the three-point contest.
Don't care.
The All-Star game. But
so did Dirk.
Yeah. But, yeah, I would agree with you. He's not all that he's making himself out to be. Now, he does put up solid numbers.
Yep.
His teams never have had any kind of playoff success. I would be leaning towards no on this one. But it's still early. I mean, he could eventually become, you know, better than he is right now.
Yeah. I was going to be a very, very marginal yes, but I'm fine with no.
I'll say no to him as well. Moving into 2016, Philadelphia 76ers. Who did they pick number one?
Well, it's got to be the center, Embiid.
Ben Simmons.
With the first pick in the 2016 NBA draft, the Philadelphia 76ers select Ben Simmons from Melbourne, Australia and Louisiana State University.
Not Embiid. It was Ben Simmons out of LSU. Now, first couple of years of Ben Simmons' career, he was pretty good. But he's been injured the last, 2 years and then decided he didn't want to play for mental reasons.
Yes. And he's a guard who went 5 years before he made a three.
He's 6'11".
He's the point forward. But you're right. He can't shoot from beyond, 15 feet.
He's also right-handed, but he shoots left-handed.
Yeah, there's a lot of weird stuff about Ben Simmons.
Yeah, I say no.
I think he needs to go somewhere smaller where it's not so much as on him.
Yeah.
But he's not a 1-1. If I got to worry about your mindset, you're not a 1-1.
Yeah. If you were to go back and ask Philadelphia if they regretted taking Ben Simmons, they would probably say
what was that year's draft?
Yeah, so Brandon Ingram, pretty good. Jaylen Brown, pretty good. Dragan Bender, not. Chris Dunn, Buddy Hield, Jamal Murray. Marquise Chris, quick pass through Dallas. Jacob Pirtle. Pirtle.
Am I not turtly enough for the Turtle Club?
All right, so we'll say no to Ben Simmons. Moving into 2017, do you guys remember who went 1-1 in 2017?
Who's the team?
What team?
Philadelphia. Had back-to-back.
That would not be Embiid. Oh, wait, is that the one that can't shoot?
Yes.
Markelle Fultz. Yeah.
With the first pick in the 2017 NBA draft, the Philadelphia 76ers select Markelle Fultz from the University of Washington.
From the University of Washington.
That was a terrible 1-1.
If Ben Simmons didn't count, then Markelle Fultz definitely does not count. And he's already been traded.
Is he even still in the league?
I think he's still in the league. I think I want to say he got traded to Orlando. But yeah, he was a massive spare when he was
with still with Orlando, only played in 18 games last year.
Yeah, I don't think they ever fixed this.
He averaged 10 points a game when he played, almost 11. When he played okay. I don't know why he only played 18 games. Maybe he was hurt still.
Because
the year before, he only played 8 games.
There is still time for him to try and right the ship with his
career. Definitely not a 1-1.
But yeah, he's not a 1-1 right now. All right, moving into 2018, the Phoenix Suns selected somebody 1-1. Do you guys remember who that was?
Ayton.
The first pick in the 2018 NBA draft, the Phoenix Suns select DeAndre Ayton from Nassau, Bahamas and the University of Arizona.
Yes, that is correct. DeAndre Ayton, who just recently re-signed with the Suns after potentially wanting to leave.
Now, there is a 1-1 in this draft.
Yeah.
He just happened to go 3.
Actually, there's several 1-1s in that draft.
There's really not. There's just one.
I mean, there's other players in there that would be good.
Like, there's players in there that is probably the best player. Like if Trae Young got drafted a different year, I would count him as a one.
Maybe. He's borderline. He is Iverson without being Iverson, because he ain't a killer.
Yeah.
Iverson's a killer. But he's got a long way to go. He can certainly be that. But I know you're not talking about Bagley, and I know you're not talking about Jaren Jackson or Mo Bamba or Wendell Carter. No. Colin Sexton's pretty good, but he's got head problems. Shea Gregis-Alexander's good, but he's all by himself. There's some good players in there, but there's no 1-1. The only 1-1 for sure is Luka.
And Jaren Jackson Jr. is pretty good, but he's been injured a lot.
Yeah.
Would you guys consider Ayton a 1-1 right now?
No.
I mean, so I would say no, just because I saw what we did to him, how the deficiencies in his game, that we basically ran him off the floor at times. The biggest thing for me is the fact that Phoenix didn't even want to give him the contract.
Yeah.
But they had to be made to do it by Indiana signing him to a restricted free agent deal, and then they just happened to match it. But they wouldn't give him his deal. He's a 1-1, and they wouldn't give him his second contract? That tells me that they know stuff about him that we don't know. We can say yes, because he certainly has good numbers, and it is awfully early. I mean, we're getting to the point now where we're talking, this guy's only played four years.
He's definitely a get back to me later. Like, I would say right now, no.
But he averages over 10 rebounds every year. And he's a 16, 18, 14, 17 game scorer. So in his young career, he's a solid 16 and 10 guy.
But not dominant, right? And he's not carrying his team.
He's the third best player, maybe the fourth best player on the team.
Yeah.
Say no. So as of right now, I would say no.
Could eventually be a guest.
All right. 2019. We're getting into some recent drafts now. The Pelicans selected somebody 1-1. Do you guys remember?
Oh, Zion.
With the first pick in the 2019 NBA Draft, the New Orleans Pelicans select Zion Williamson from Duke University.
That would be Zion Williams. Now, Zion...
incomplete.
...has talent, but he has been injured so often, and he just seems also like he's never in shape. Looks like he should be playing football instead of basketball. Yeah. Also a head case, like you said. Could potentially be a good player at some point.
I saw that draft.
Oh, Jesus.
So, I'll tell you what, the guy taken behind him is the 1-1 that year.
Oh, Jean Morant?
Yeah, that's your 1-1.
Well, if he's playing, he's not. Because if he's playing, this dude is a 22-point game scorer as a rookie, but it was for 24 games.
Yeah.
And then the next year he scored 27 a game, but it was for 61 games. And that's it. We haven't seen him since 2021.
Yeah, there's a lot of red flags there. I would say if you ask New Orleans who they would want to pick in that draft if they were redrafting, they would not take Zion Williams.
He's got the potential to be a version of Barkley, but he's not there yet.
Yeah, I would agree. It's early on it, but you have to say no. I want to say yes because he averaged 27 a game.
Just the sample size. The sample size is just too small.
Well, I mean, that's going to be the case for the next two guys.
Using that kind of as an example, if you look at 2020, Minnesota, do you remember who they took?
Anthony Edwards.
With the first pick in the 2020 NBA Draft, the Minnesota Timberwolves select Anthony Edwards from the University of Georgia.
What was his name? Hermit something in Hustle?
Oh, that's right. He was the dude in Hustle also.
I would count Anthony Edwards more than I would count Zion just because he's played more games. They've actually gone to the playoffs. And he has shown more from a scoring standpoint than I think Zion has.
No. Zion scores 27 a game. This dude scores 19 and 21.
Zion scored
27 a game in 60 games. That's tough for anybody. 27 is a lot. His problem is that he's not healthy. When healthy, that dude's a monster.
Yeah, these numbers are pretty good, but it's too early.
He's 21 points,
incomplete.
5 rebounds, 3 assists. They're good numbers. He's a really good player. I think Anthony Edwards is fantastic. And he's certainly, given we only have 2 years, I have no issues with him being the 1-1 that year. He's certainly better than Wiseman at 2.
That's why I was going to say, if you were to go back and ask Minnesota if they were happy with Anthony Edwards, would they say yes?
They probably would.
They wouldn't change the pick. I mean, they're not going to take Wiseman. He hasn't been healthy. LaMelo Ball, certainly not better than Edwards. He definitely is the best player in that draft. And I think in the very short time that we've seen him, I think he's definitely worthy of the first
pick. Yeah, so I would say yes.
But he's a yes, but 5 years from now, we might have a different take.
Yeah, he's definitely a 1-1 trash talk. Hey, is that your daughter up there?
That's your little girl over there? What's her name? Easy, boy. Acting like I asked her out or something. I'm just trying to get to know you.
So now we come up to 2021, and Detroit took somebody last year.
Cade Cunningham.
With the first pick in the 2021 NBA draft, the Detroit Pistons select Cade Cunningham from Oklahoma State University.
That would be Cade Cunningham. Obviously, way too early.
Big Cowboy fan.
He had a decent year, but I don't think he was the rookie of the year. Was he?
Close friend of the Jones family.
Nice.
Who was rookie of the year last year? Sure, but fucking
was it? Primo. Was it Barnes? I want to say Barnes, maybe.
Yeah, it might have been Barnes.
He has some talent.
17. That's not bad.
Yeah, but he's a stat filler. So it's 17 plus 5.5 rebounds plus 5.5 assists.
Wow.
On a bad team. He's a really good young player.
You were born in Arlington.
I just got through. He's a close personal friend of the Jones family. He's from Milwaukee. He used to go be a ball boy at Cowboys training camp because he's one of the grandsons.
Yeah.
Is his best friend.
Oh, wow. Very nice.
Would you say yes with just our limited data that we have right now?
I'm a yes for right now. There's nothing right after him that I would say I'd absolutely rather have.
I would say yes for right now, too.
Yeah, the last two, then I would say both him and Anthony Edwards.
All right. Well, then that concludes our list. Obviously, the person that went 1-1 this year, we can't tell because they haven't played any games yet.
But he came out in summer league and played really good in the first game. And then they didn't let him play in any more games because they'd seen what they wanted to see.
Paolo
Banchero.
With the first pick in the 2022 NBA draft, the Orlando Magic select Paolo Banchero from Duke University.
Yeah, I think Banchero will end up being really good.
But Chet Holmgren may end up being the 1-1 because you were dead wrong about that guy. You thought he was going to be a scrub and a half. It's only summer league, but there was nothing that dude couldn't do out there.
He's just too skinny. He's going to get shoved around like a
monster. No, he's going to be good too. All right, so compiling our yeses, we ended up with 12.
Wow.
Gary hit the number on the head. 12 yeses. Gary was a 12. He wins both showcases. So congratulations to Gary.
I try to tell you guys, it doesn't matter whether you're talking about the NBA draft or the NFL draft or any of the other drafts, the bust rate is so high. And you guys think it's just us. Oh, you drafted Taco that one time. Yeah, one time we drafted Taco.
Now, not all of them were busts, complete busts. Some of them were decent players.
Yeah, I'd say about half of the ones we said no to were right on the borderline.
Yeah, there was a lot of decent players that ended up having good NBA careers. But
it's 1-1.
But yeah, Gary's
1-10.
Yeah, Gary's right. In terms of living up to the 1-1 status, it's a very limited number over the last 30 years. Gary, do you want to give us any Twitter information that you want us to follow?
Yeah, you can follow me at @travel_cowboy on Twitter. And if you want to hear about cowboy talk, you can listen to @fixitrich on Twitter.
Bob?
Yeah, I would also recommend listening to Fix It Rich on Twitter. Yeah, my Twitter handle is lukewarmtallboy. Long story.
And if you want to reach the show, you can reach us on Twitter @howmanypodcast. If you want to reach me directly, @Metzigan_junior on Twitter. You can also email us, howmanypodcast@gmail.com. You can also check out our YouTube channel, our Facebook page, lots of different ways to get a hold of us. Thank you guys for entertaining this topic, and we will talk to you soon.
I like the way the dribble up and down the court, just like out the king on the microphone. So adopt the J and Moses Malone.